cebuka.
Jesus, begin to love, appreciate God, worship Him, give Him praise. He's a reliable God, and today we are standing before the Lord God Almighty, declaring the 2020 convention open. Let in the labos, in the lava shandolo godoyera, limarandolo, and Christ has given us a team. That Jesus is all that matters. Let in so no robotico. Lord, we thank you. We glorify you. We exalt your majesty. Lord, it's all about you, Lord. We give you all the praise. We give you all the adoration. We thank you, Lord. The whole earth shall sing your praise. The whole earth shall sing your praise. The whole earth shall sing your praise. Because you are reliable. You are the unchangeable God. And with you, Lord, all things are possible. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. Wherever you are in any part of the world, I want to say you are welcome to 2020 convention of Powerflow Gospel Ministry worldwide. We give God all the glory. Grace cannot be locked down. The word of God must be heard. We give Him all the praise. Thank you, Jesus. The theme is Jesus Christ is all that matter. That is the theme of 2020 convention. Jesus Christ is all that matters. It's all that matters. And I know that it's going to reveal Himself to you more than ever before. All through this week, as we keep hitting on different topics by the grace of God. So just open up your heart. Begin to follow up in any part of the world. And the Lord is going to do something unusual in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. We give you all the thanks in Jesus' name. I say again, you are welcome to 2020 convention. In this year, that's a unique year. We give Him all the glory. I will be speaking on a topic today, the ultimate sacrifice. The ultimate sacrifice. And under the theme, Jesus Christ is all that matter. Looking at this topic today, the ultimate sacrifice is all about Jesus. Because there are sacrifices here and there. But Jesus Christ is the ultimate sacrifice. The ultimate sacrifice. I would like you to take note of Isaiah 53 from verse 1 to the ending, and as well as John 19, 1 to the ending. So I will pick some verses at the course of my talking inside this text. I will as well refer to other texts, because Christ is the ultimate sacrifice. When you know that he had been shed for you, where you know he has spilled his blood and he has paid all the price, he has done all that should be done, there's nothing you will be afraid of again. So Jesus Christ is the ultimate sacrifice. He's the one to be presented to the world this time. He said, if the Son of Man be lifted up, he will draw men unto himself. The time is now. Just as the Lord said to me, said when I was praying, meditating about the theme of this year, 2020, about the convention, about the theme, the Lord said to me, my son, this is the time to cry to the whole world that Jesus is all that matter. This is the time to cry aloud to the global world, to cry aloud to mankind, to cry aloud to the whole world that Jesus Christ is all that matter. I don't know what you have been pursuing, what have taken the place of God, or you have not even given your life to Christ, or you are just a church goer. The time is now. You better know it now so that things will not go worse. You better give yourself now. It is the hour of visitation. There are things you should not meet now. You should not miss now. Because Christ is all that matter. He has paid it all. As you hear this and as you understand it, you will not only be a receptor. That is, you will not only be a receiver. You will begin to propagate this gospel. You will begin to say it in your closet. Say it in the open. Say it to nations that Jesus is all that matter. And as you get it online, begin to share it. Let it go around the whole world that Jesus is all that matters. That Jesus is all that matters. Because when you do this now, Christ is able to perfect all that concerns you. He's going to make out of your life what he wants to make. This is not a joking time. It's a serious matter. Because when the Lord said, cry it to the world that Jesus Christ is all that matter. So looking at this topic of today, the ultimate sacrifice. The sacrifice that Jesus had made does not have equal. Right from Genesis, when things went wrong in the Garden of Eden, when Adam and Eve ignorantly handed over the kingdom to Satan, then from there, God looked around and said to Adam in Genesis 3:15, that out of thy seed, out of thy loins, I will bring out a seed that will bruise serpent on his head, and it can only bruise his heels. He was talking about Jesus to come and pay and get us redeemed. Pay the debt. Pay the price of sin. Give all that we need. It was not easy for Christ. He was God and he's God himself. That the scripture had made known to us. But he has to take the shape of man. He has to take the form of man. Unto us, a son is what? Is given. Unto us, a child is born. We have to take the human form of being born so that he can take over that which Satan have taken and restore it. He paid the ultimate sacrifice. He paid the ultimate sacrifice. John the Baptist was sent as a forerunner of the Lord Jesus Christ. 6 months before, 6 months, the mother of John the Baptist, Elizabeth, was pregnant, having gotten a message from the angel of the Lord, Angel Gabriel. And 6 months later, the same angel went to Mary, delivering a message that the seed was planted by the Holy Ghost, not by any man, but taking the shape of a man so that he can suffer the suffering for us. He can pay the price. He can offer himself as the ultimate sacrifice. You need to know that what Jesus went through was not what easy. You need to know that it was not easy. That is this time you understand, if you reject this great sacrifice, this great thing that Christ have done, if you reject it now, that is free of charge, you have no place of escape. Whether the world like it or not, there's no any other God that's going to judge the world. It is the Lord Jesus Christ. Every other religion will be judged. Every other way will be judged. Because in John 14, verse 6, he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except by me. He is the only way. There's no other way. He paid the ultimate sacrifice. No wonder Isaiah cried out in Isaiah 53. I'll just pick some verses right now. But if you look at verse 1 in Isaiah 53, he said, who had believed our report? Who has believed our report? Who has believed our report? To whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? It was a deep revelation. It was a concealed thing that was made known. He was the lamb to be slain. 800 years before Christ was born, Isaiah prophesied it. He prophesied it. That a virgin will give birth to a son. He cried in Isaiah 53, he said so much about Jesus. That's why I started by saying, who has believed our report? To whom is the arm of God revealed? Hallelujah. If you look at verse 3 of that Isaiah 53, it says he was despised and what? Rejected. He was despised and rejected. A man of sorrow and acquainted with griefs. And we hid as it were our face from him. He was despised, and we esteem him not. Look at verse 4. Surely he had borne our griefs, he has carried our sorrow, yet we did not esteem him stricken, smitten of God and afflicted. It was a deliberate act of God, because when there was a cry from heaven, who will go for us? Who is that lamb to be slain? It was Jesus that offered himself. So that's why he said, he was what? Despised. He was rejected. He carried our sorrow. Though we didn't esteem him, he was smitten of God and afflicted. If you look at verse 5, he said, but he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. He is the one that was wounded for our transgression, wounded for our sin, bruised for our iniquities. For the chastisement of our peace was laid upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. Jesus is the ultimate sacrifice. He offered these things. He gave it all. The lamb to be slain. Isaiah cried all these things 800 years before Christ was born. Look at verse 6. He said, oh, we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way. And the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. Your iniquity, my iniquity, the Lord laid it on the Lord Jesus Christ. He is the one that offered the ultimate sacrifice. He paid the price. You look at verse 7. He said he was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He was brought as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before his shearer is dumb, so he opened not his mouth. Christ before the shearer, Christ before those that we slaughtered him, he didn't see anything. Because why? He was the destined lamb to be what? To be slain. To offer the ultimate sacrifice that will rescue you and rescue me. That is why today we can silence the kingdoms of darkness. Because Christ paid the price.
Let me go to verse 10.
That will move forward. But take note, you can take note of the entire Ezra 53 and study them again and again.
Look at verse 10. Yet it pleased the Lord to bruise him. He hath put him to grief. When thou shalt make his soul an offering of sin, when thou shalt make his soul an offering for sin, he shall see his seed, and he shall prolong his days, and the pleasures of the Lord shall prosper in his hand.
Look at that verse 10.
It pleased the Lord to bruise him. It pleased the Lord to bruise him. It pleased the Lord to bruise him. He had put him to grief. He was wounded. He was crushed, as verse 4 we say. It pleased the Lord. Just because Christ offered himself as a lamb to be slain. That's why in Revelation 12, he said, there's the lamb. As a lamb to be slain. John the Baptist gave an account of this. If you look at John chapter 1, John the Baptist himself gave an account. He didn't know the Lord Jesus when Christ was on earth. But the Holy Ghost made it known to him. He knew that he was a forerunner for Christ. He knows it. But if you look at John chapter 1, when study that account also, the entire John chapter 1, a time came the Pharisees and the scribes were questioning him, who are you? He said, I'm the one, the forerunner. But somebody's coming after me. He's greater than I. His shoe, I'm not even worthy to untie. But I'm not the deliverer. I'm not the Messiah. I am a forerunner. Hallelujah. I'm a forerunner. They say, I came to bear witness. He's the one that's coming for me. The fullness of grace is in him. If you look at verse 19. Let me read verse 19 now. Okay, let me take from verse 18, John chapter 1, so that you understand it very clearer here. It said, no man has seen God at any time. The only begotten Son, who is in the bosom of the Father, he had declared him. Look at verse 19. And this is the record of John, whom the Jews sent prince, the Levite, from Jerusalem to ask him, who art thou? Verse 20. And he confessed and denied not, but confessed, I am not the Christ. But they asked him, who then art thou? Art thou Elijah? Art thou the prophet? Let's move forward. He said to them, no. In verse 23, he said, In verse 23, he said, I am the voice of the one crying in the wilderness. Make straight the way of the Lord, as said the prophet Isaiah. Hallelujah. Then let's go to verse 28. He said, these things were done in Bethabara beyond Jordan, where John was baptizing. Then verse 29, he said, the next day John seeth Jesus coming unto him and said, behold the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world. Can somebody shout hallelujah? Behold the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world. The lamb to be slain. And this was how Jesus was made known. If you look at the following verse. Verse 30. It said, this is he whom I said. Because he had been talking about him. He said, now this is him whom I said, after me cometh a man which is preferred before me, for he was before me. And I knew him not, verse 31. And what? I knew him not, but that he should be made manifest to Israel. Therefore, I am baptizing with water. And John bear record saying, I saw the Spirit descending from heaven like a dove, and it abode upon what? Upon him. Verse 3, I knew him not, but he said, but he that sent me, listen to this verse 33 very well. Verse 3, just saying again with emphasis, he said, I knew him not, but he that sent me to baptize, but he that sent me to baptize. I take that verse 3 again. I knew him not, but he that sent me to baptize with water, the same said unto me, upon whom thou seest the Spirit descending and remaining on him, the same is he. Hallelujah. The same is he. That is, John the Baptist did not even know him. It was when he saw the Holy Ghost descended upon him, and heaven descended, and the Holy Ghost remained. He said, this is the one. Because the Lord who sent me to be baptizing with water have earlier said to me that upon whom I see the Holy Ghost descend and it remained on him, the same is he which baptized with the Holy Ghost fire. Can somebody shout Holy Ghost fire? Can you scream in the second time? Can you scream in the third time? Thank you, Jesus. Upon whom I see the Holy Ghost come. Because then, when the Holy Ghost come upon a man, he uses the person after that he goes. He said, but can you see him? The Holy Ghost come and he descend and it remains. He said, that is the Lamb. That's why John the Baptist scream and introduce him to the whole world. Even Satan did not know Jesus. Hallelujah. That's a mystery for another day. It was when John the Baptist declared him. That was even when Satan could recognize and say, wow, I thought I have killed him when I made Herod to kill children of 2 years old. Nothing will kill you. You will fulfill your destiny. You will be everything God wants you to be. In the mighty name of Jesus. Because Jesus is all that matters. He has offered the ultimate sacrifice. The Lord packaged you to planet Earth for a purpose. And that purpose will accomplish. If you are in agreement with me, can I say, I receive. Lekintos in Palagadea. That was how he was made known that this is the Lamb of God that is out to be slain, to pay the price. Jesus, the ultimate sacrifice. I want to let you know that the sacrifice was not easy for Jesus. It was not easy. It was not a joking matter. If you have studied the synoptic gospel, by the book of Matthew, Luke, and John, if you have studied then to see how Christ suffered just because he wants to get you free, because he wants to get you rescued, it is not a joking matter to get us rescued. So we looked, that's why I said, read through John chapter 19. Hallelujah. If you look at it from verse 1, John chapter 19, he said, Pilate took Jesus and scourged him. Pilate took Jesus and what? And scourged him. Hallelujah. He scourged him. Because he decided to die for your sin and my sin. He decided to pay the price. There's a lot of pains. There's a lot of suffering. And as I already told us, he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. By his stripes, we are what? Healed. They were accomplishing this punishment in Christ, but not knowing they were fulfilling the scripture. Looking at scourging, if you study the scripture, Pilate wanted to even free him because he felt this man have not done anything, so he should be let go. But the Jews insisted, no, he should not be allowed to go. He has violated our laws. He has blasphemed against our law. He has called himself the king. Just to entangle Pilate, they said, Pilate, if you free him, then you are not a friend to Caesar. Because Caesar is the only leader we know. You know, some persons, out of ignorance or out of wanting on the other, because you want to deal with one or the other, you begin to put yourself into some enslavement. They said, we are under Caesar. They rejected Christ, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. But they didn't know they were leading him to the path for him to offer what? The ultimate word, sacrifice. They told Pilate, if you look at verse 6 in this John 19, verse 6, he said, when the chief priest, therefore, an officer saw him, they cried out, saying, crucify him, crucify him. Pilate said unto them, take ye him yourself and crucify him, for I found no fault in him. I found no fault in him. But they insisted. Pilate had no alternative than to take him in again and begin to question him and begin to ask him questions, because the Jews said he need to die. He need to die. But not knowing, they were just fulfilling God's agenda for him to offer the ultimate sacrifice. If you look at verse 8, he said, Pilate therefore heard the saying of the Jews, he became more what? Afraid. And he went again to judgment seat. He had to sit again on judgment seat and begin to question Jesus. Hallelujah. Look at verse 10 here. John 19:10. Then said Pilate unto him, speakest thou not unto me? Knowest thou not that I have power to crucify thee? And have power to release thee. He was questioning Jesus. He didn't talk. He didn't understand. This is a lamb to be slain. We have read it in Isaiah 53 verse 10. And in verse 4. It pleased the Lord to bruise him. That's what verse 10 says in Isaiah 53. Smitten of God and afflicted. Just because John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. He gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believe in him will not perish, but shall have what? Eternal life. That was how Christ lifted up his head and looked at Pilate. Verse 11 of John 19. Jesus answered, thou couldest have no power at all against me, except it were given thee from above. Therefore, he that delivereth me unto thee had the greater sin. God have allowed you so that I can fulfill who I'm on earth. To say, I should talk so that you can free me. You have power to free me. You have power to deliver me to death. Jesus looked at him. He didn't know he was speaking to the creator of the heaven and earth. He was speaking to the one who said, let me tell Pharaoh that I am, that I am. Christ was humiliated. He was scourged. He bore those pains.
I pray for somebody this evening. Whatsoever is reproaching your life, whatsoever is humiliating your destiny, like in those impalados in Calado, because Christ beat it all. He was scourged, he was bruised, he was despised, he was rejected, because he wants you and I to be free. He wants us to be glorified. He never turned back. He took the whole thing. I decree and I declare, your humiliation has expired. Your oppression has expired. Your calamity has expired. Your backwardness has expired. Intolerable, Alado. All you just need to understand that Jesus Christ is all that matters. He has paid the ultimate sacrifice. There's nothing you need to do again. All you need is to allow him to take over your life. Holy Ghost, Masandaladoa, Masantolodo, to move forward. And at the long run, that's how he was delivered. And then he carried the cross. He was being scourged. He started carrying the cross. He suffered a lot of things. A lot of pain was inflicted on him. He started screaming and they were scourging him. And then the soldiers, they haven't scourged him. They took thorns and thistles and they created a crown. In our vernacular language, we call it chukuchuku. That is, they now use it to make a crown. Thorns and thistles, and then they press it hard on his head, and those thorns and thistles pierce his head, and blood were gushing out, and Christ beared it because he wants to offer the ultimate sacrifice, the sacrifice that is above every other sacrifice. That's why if you understand this, there's no sacrifice that can hold you backward made by man. He beared it. And at the long run, he was being led to Golgotha, suffering the pain, a lot of afflictions, an attack. He beared it. My son, Tolobonea. In the midst of those pain, in the midst of those things he was bearing, at a stage he had to cry unto his father. This time he was already hung on the cross, because when they took him to Golgotha, they laid him on the cross. They nailed his left hand, they nailed his right hand, and they crossed his leg together. They nailed it, not knowing it was all fulfillment of what Christ needs to suffer. Having laid him on the cross, they lifted him up with that cross, and then they pinned the cross to the ground. And to his left side and to his right side, they crucified also two deadly armed robbers that have taken a lot of souls, because he died with criminal, because he wants to pay for our sin. That's why all you need, if you can repent of your sin and surrender to Christ, there's nothing that can hold you back. You'll be cleansed. You know, at a stage, Jesus Christ have to cry in the cross of Calvary. Eli, 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 lama sabachthani. Meaning, my God, my God, my God, why have thou forsaken me? It was a half-fed word. He was not joking. That thing cried from his heart, because the pain was so much. The pain became unbearable. He looked at himself, the Lord of loss, the King of Kings, because I decided to offer myself as a lamb, suffering this pain. He that walked upon the waters, he that opened the eyes of the blind man that was born, that became blind from birth, in John chapter 9. He that the woman with the issue of blood touched in Mark chapter 5, just touching the clothes, the blood that had been flowing for 12 years stops. He that came across a widow with a son, the widow that is called the widow of Nae, and in the only, he is a widow because he has lost the husband, and in the long run lost the only child, because the devil takes delight in seeing pain and afflictions. That's why when Satan takes anything from you, if you start crying, he will take another one. All you need is to locate God. Just touching that son of that widow of Nae that was already been taken to the grave, the Bible says the young man sat up. He that brought the dead Lazarus out from grave after 4 days, because he decided to offer himself suffering pain. God, take note of this. Do you know that God, this God we say is a merciful God. Give me first chance. Give me second chance. Give me third chance. Give me last chance. I tell you today, you need to understand, if God can forsake Jesus, his only beloved son, on the cross of Calvary, You are a trash to be forgotten. If you didn't make use of the available opportunity now that is free of charge, that is free of charge. Salvation is free. It costs you nothing. All you need is just to believe, and then you accept Christ into your life, and then you are free. If you didn't accept it now and begin to grow in it now, time is coming, it will be too late. Because if God can forsake Jesus on the cross, you think that cry was a cry of joke? You think it's a cry of drama? You think it's a cry? It was out of pain. Excruciative pain. Pain that cannot be explained. The Lord forsook him on the cross because he decided to take your sin and my sin. The Lord left him on the cross of Calvary. Hallelujah. Amen. Was in that pain and thereabout. And something happened. Hallelujah. In that same John 19, from verse 28. After this, Jesus, knowing that, I take verse 28 again, John chapter 19, verse 28. After this, Jesus, knowing that all things were now accomplished. Jesus, knowing that all things were now what? Accomplished. That the scripture might be fulfilled, said, I thirst. Verse 29. And there was set a vessel full of vinegar. Full of vinegar. Vinegar is one of the most bitter substances. You are looking for bitter things on earth, vinegar is one of them. So that test, and then they took a vessel full of vinegar and they filled a sponge with vinegar and put it upon his hyssop and put it in his mouth. Verse 30. When Jesus therefore had received the vinegar, he said, it is finished. And he bowed his head and gave up his ghost. The ultimate sacrifice. If you understand this mystery, there's no power that can humiliate you.
not touch anywhere. I have too much to say, most especially in my village crusade experiences. If you are talking of sacrifices, you are talking of powers, you are talking of demons and deities in their strongholds, you go into some interior villages where demons rule in those territories. I remember a crusade. This was 2001. This is about 21 years ago. That's about 19 years ago. 2001? Yeah, 19 years ago. About 19 years ago. When a village was held to ransom, no church could even survive that village. Many churches went, they couldn't. They couldn't. They kept closing up. There was one man who is evangelistic in nature. He was sent from a missionary church, and he was there. He tried to stay, tried to penetrate. At the long run, the forces the land is dedicated to still had their way. And he was crumbled out of that place. The benches they were using the church, the villagers shed them and started using it to sit down in the front of their houses. I was in Enugu that 2001 when the Lord said to me in Enugu in Nigeria here, when the Lord said to me in that Enugu state, when the Lord said to me, my son, go to those villages and liberate them. And I started, having fasted and prayed, when the Lord unfolded to me in the miseries of that village, and how some ancestral parents have sold that village to a deity in the water, and that is the forces that is ruling. It was a very serious matter. But because of this type of understanding that Jesus is the ultimate sacrifice, I told myself, those fallen angels must be driven out, sent to the bottomless pit, the people must be free. And really, went. I did not even just begin to pray at home. I said, we need to go to that river, address those fallen angels. If you listen to my message dealing with ancestral evil power and territorial evil deities, you will understand some miseries. Casted out those fallen angels. But stepping into that water, the demons reacted. And the demons said, this is his own territory, and nothing takes it. That has been there for centuries upon centuries. The demon said, I bought this place, and this is how I bought it. This is who bought it. Who sold it to me? And the man who sold it to me, I empowered the man. And really, that man, he was celebrated in the entire Edo land, the entire Edo state, as a very strong and notable principality. A strong and notable diviners. Even the palace celebrated him. But not knowing he has engaged the destiny of generations that are not yet born. They said, this man is demonic power. Does not even take any transport. He always used divine flight. A lot of mysteries were unfolded. But at the long run, the dentist in that river said, I bought it. I said, yes, I've come to buy it back, to redeem it. He said, what am I going to use? Now he bought it with 14 kobo. And with that 14 covenant, I said, but I've come to buy it with the blood of Jesus. Because why? The blood of Jesus is the redemptive power in Christ. And with the blood of Jesus, that place was what? Was redeemed. Thank you, Jesus. Because of time, at the long run, that village got their freedom. Churches could not stay. Hundreds of people gave their life in that crusade, which I handed over. That became the beginning. This was 2001. That became the beginning of Pentecostal churches able to not settle in that village. All to the glory of God. Because I know Jesus is the ultimate sacrifice. There was a time also, they said a king of a village did a sacrifice because the youth listened to the word of God. A crusade I went to preach. And then they cut down an evil tree. The king was provoked. The king said, that evil tree, we call it, he says, it's we that said evil tree, he said, that is what is protecting them. That is the deity they have been serving. He went across some cities, some nations, brought in seven native daughters to come and curse the youth that cut that tree. They did sacrifice on that community, and the whole people were afraid. When I heard, I left Lagos to Edo State, and I went to that village. When they saw me, they were happy. They said, this is their challenge now. I said, fear not. What did he sacrifice? They said, he sacrificed goat. That's what those seven notable native daughters did. I told them that day, you people should come and take me to the place so that I can as well offer my sacrifice. They say, our pastor wants to do sacrifice. I opened their understanding. They just use the blood of goat. I said, but after the blood of goat, even the human being, whether blood or their parts, that's why you see some demonic politicians, some demonic individuals, some demonic and occultic people. They look for human parts and human blood to sacrifice. Because why? They know that that one is more potent than that of any animal. I told them that day in that community, there is a sacrifice that is ultimate. There's what? A sacrifice that is what? Ultimate. That is the blood of Jesus. It's still flowing. Just this way he was released in over 2,000 years ago. That blood is still flowing till tomorrow. I say it's higher than any other human sacrifice. Take me to the place. Let me offer my own sacrifice. Children of God, you need to know whom you are. Take dominion. And they took me to the trench that was dug by those seven notable native daughters that is dread in that state. And on the long run, I stepped into the place. I said they should give me a bucket of water. And they gave me a bucket of water. I put my head inside that bucket of water. And I decree and I declare, turning that water to the blood of Jesus. That prayer was less than 5 minutes. I took the content now, which is the blood of Jesus. I poured it on that trench. And I returned the curse to the sender. And I released blessings upon the youth and upon the land. Beloved, it became a mystery. This one happened around 2006. Amen. It's about 14 years now. It's still a celebrated issue. Because Jesus is the ultimate sacrifice. Even the king and those that were involved, all of them were held to ransom by the power of God. It was a big disgrace and reproach because the power of God humiliated them. So I want you to stand wherever you are, celebrating the King of Kings, celebrating the Lord of Lords, celebrating that He is the ultimate sacrifice. There's no one that is like unto Him. There's no one that can be compared unto Him. I want you to celebrate. Join me, celebrate Jesus. Join me, celebrate Jesus. Wherever you are, in any part of the world, join me, celebrate Jesus.
let me celebrate Jesus. He is the Lord of Lords. He is the King of Kings. He is the Ancient of Days. He is the first. He is the last. There is no one that is like unto him. Great God he is. Oh Jesus, you are the one that matter. All power belongs to you. What a great God you are. I worship you, Lord. I give you all the adoration. Father, you paid the price. You paid it all. You died the death. You died for us. You have paid it all. What else do we want? The whole world must know. Are you ready to start crying it aloud? The whole world must know that Jesus is the ultimate sacrifice. That Jesus is all that matter. That beside him there's no one else. Holy my Alados in Telelat. Yes. Oh, you will get to where you are going. You will be all that God wants you to be. The counsel of the wicked will not be accomplished. Jesus, oh Jesus, what a wonderful name, what a wonderful name, what a wonderful name is Jesus, what a wonderful name is Jesus, what a wonderful name is Jesus. No wonder the Bible gave him a name that is highly exalted, a name above every other name, that in the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ, he is the Lord. Jesus, I thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Holy Ghost, I thank you. Holy Ghost, I thank you, Lord. Let your take over that family, take over that home, take over that nation, take over that community, take over that continent that is looking unto you. Jesus, oh Jesus, you have given me a mandate, you have given me an assignment to cry to the whole world that Jesus, you are the one that matters. Every ear must hear it, the earth must hear it, the living must hear it, to the glory of your name. Holy Ghost. In Canada, Abba Father, this word of salvation, Abba Father, the death we hear it, Abba Father, even the death with the blind we see it. Oh Jesus, 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 you are all that matter. Oh, thank you, Lord. Begin to say, Jesus, take over my life, take over my home. Take over my business. Take over all I'm doing. Use me for your purpose. Can somebody scream? Say, Jesus, Jesus, you are the one that matter. You are the one that matter. You are the one that matter to me. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name. I pray for you today that this thing will begin to... This voice that is saying Jesus Christ is all that matter, we begin to cry in your spirit, man. Deeper revelations and insight you begin to get. You will live for Jesus. That's all that matters. You live for Jesus. That's all that matters. We live for Jesus. The ultimate sacrifice has been sacrificed. The ultimate sacrifice has been done. No going backward. Grace upon you in the name of Jesus. Jesus, I declare you lifted up in the whole world. Everything contrary must go down. Your name must be glorified. Every other tongues must be silenced, whether physical or spiritual. In the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. It's going to be a global turnaround, a global miracle, a global impact in the midst of this week. By the reason of this revelation God has given me,
that cry to the whole world that Jesus is all that matter. Something unique is going to happen this week. Make a vow to the whole world in the name of Jesus. It has started already. The Lord will keep manifesting it. What a great God. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name.